Okay, hi, Bohan. Today our session is about human resource planning. Manava Sampath Salasunkaraniya. So hopefully after studying this chapter successfully and also listening to the lecture successfully, you will be able to achieve these six objectives, which we consider as learning outcomes. Okay, then definition. Human resource planning is the process of determining future employee needs and deciding steps or strategies to achieve those needs for the purpose of accomplishing organizational goals and objectives. So, we have an organization and that has organizational goals and objectives. To achieve these organizational goals and objectives, we have to have employees. We have to have employees. So, human resource planning is a systematic attempt that involves determining future employee needs. Then, after determining future employee needs, this process involves deciding steps or strategies to achieve those future employee needs. What do you mean by future employee needs? Future, you can understand. Then employee needs means number of employees and the types of employees. For example, types can include management assistant, production associate, production supervisor, marketing manager, human resource manager. They are considered as types of jobs. Types of jobs. And then if you take one type, then how many employees do we need? 10 employees, 5 employees, only one employee. So likewise, the number of employees and the types of employees for the future, at least for the next year. If the future is a long-term one, then maybe more than 3 years. So even we can do human resource planning for a period of 5 years. Or for a period of 3 years. So what we call is time horizon. Time horizon. So if it is a short-term future, usually it is 1 year or less than 1 year. Less than 1 year. So that this one is considered as a very important human resource function. So that has a focus on providing the organization with an adequate manpower in order to achieve goals of the organization. Educate, sufficient, pramanavat, manosampat, balaya. Pramanavat, manosampat, balayak, minis balayak, avashyai ayatane paramarth ishtakara ganima sandaha, enisa kisiyam nishchita anagata kala parichchedayak thoragena, e anagata kala parichchedayata avashyavana seva dayakin sankhyaya thirne karala, ඒ සංඛ්‍යාව ඉටු කිරීමට අවශ්‍ය වන පියවරයන් තීරණය කිරීමේ විධිමත් ක්‍රියාවලියක් තමයි මානව සම්පත් සැලසුම් කරණය කියන එකෙන් අදහස් කරන්නේ. Then what is the main objective of human resource planning? That is to prepare the organization to acquire the more appropriate, if not the most appropriate employees, the more appropriate employees on the more appropriate jobs at the more appropriate times, so that overall organizational goals are attained. So in simple, we have to provide the organization with the right number of employees on the right jobs at the right times. Then only we will be able to achieve organizational goals. So that's the main purpose of human resource planning. We have to have the right number, the right type, at the right time. So, you know, we have here the organizational goal, organizational goal or goals. So we consider primary goals of the organization. To achieve these goals, there is a major work to be done. Major work to be done. So this major work, we divide into jobs. So here we have job 1, job 2, job 3, job 4, job 5, job 6, job 7, job 8, job 9, and job 10. So then for these jobs, there are positions. There are positions. So normally the job holders 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So likewise, assume there are 100 positions relating to these jobs. There are 10 jobs, but there are 100 positions. There are 100 positions. Maybe one job has one position. Job 2, assume, has 10 positions. Job 3, 15 positions. So likewise. So altogether, 100 positions. That means we need 100 employees to do the major work so as to achieve goals of the organization. Okay, let us consider next year. Then here we have the, we should have forecast the future demand. Of human resources. Future demands of human resources. Then here we have the supply. We have the supply of human resources. How many employees within the organization, how many employees are there? Supply of human resources. Then for the next year, assume we need 10 employees for the next year, but supply of human resources 100, because we have 100 positions. So assume all the 100 positions are being performed by 100 people. So then the supply of human resources, that is 100. Then for the next year, future demand of human resources, we need 110 people. Then here then, there is, okay, the future demand of human resources is greater than the supply of human resources. 110 exceeds the 100. Then there is a shortage. Shortage of 10. So that means we have to hire new 10 people. New 10 people as employees to face this or to avoid this shortage. Assume this is situation 1. Then situation 2, future demand. future demand of human resources, assume only 90. That means for the next year, we will need only 90 employees. But the supply of human resources, so that is 100. That is 100. So then 100 exceeds 90. Then, so that means there is a shortage. Not shortage, there is a surplus. There is a surplus of 10 people. That means there are 10 employees who are in excess. These excessive employees will have to be terminated or will have to be rid of the organization. Then we will be able to have balance. We will be able to have balance. So that means we will be able to have balance. Okay, so then that is right numbers of employees for right types of jobs. Right numbers of the employees for the right types of the jobs. So this is all about human resource planning. සිංහලෙන් කිව්වොත් ආයතනයේ ප්‍රධාන පරමාර්ථ තියෙනවා. ඒ පරමාර්ථ ඉෂ්ට කිරීමට ඉටු කළ යුතු ප්‍රධාන කාර්යයක් තියෙනවා. ඒ ප්‍රධාන කාර්ය රැකියාවට බෙදලා තියෙනවා. මෙහි මෙම උදාහරණයට අනුව රැකියා 10ක් තියෙනවා. ඒ රැකියා 10 සඳහා තනතුරු 100ක් තිබෙනවා. තනතුරු 100ක් තියෙනවා. එතකොට අපි සැලසුම් කිරීම සඳහා ඊළඟ අවුරුද්ද ගන්නවා කියලා හිතමු. එතකොට ඊළඟ අවුරුද්දේ අපිට අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා ඒ කියන්නේ ඩිමාන්ඩ් එක අනාගත ඉල්ලුම සේවකින් සඳහා අනාගත ඉල්ලුම 110යි වර්තමානයේ සිටිනවා 100ක් ඒ කියන්නේ සැපයුම 100යි එතකොට සැපයුම ඉල්ලුමට වඩා වැඩි නිසා ඉල්ලුමට වඩා වැඩිද නැහැ ඉල්ලුමට වඩා අඩුයි ඒ නිසා ඉල්ලුම වැඩි එතකොට ඉල්ලුම වැඩි කියලා කියන්නේ හිඟයක් තිබෙනවා 10යක එතකොට නව සේවාදායකයන් 10 දිනක් බඳවා ගන්න ඕනේ එතකොට මේක අපි අවස්ථාව 1 කියලා ගමු එතකොට අවස්ථාව 2 හැටියට ගත්තොත් සැපයුම සීයයි නමුත් අපිට ලබන අවුරුද්ද සඳහා අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ 90යි ඒ කියන්නේ අතිරික්තයක් තියෙනවා 10යක. එතකොට මේ මානව සම්පත් සැලසුම් කරෙන් අදහස් කරන්නේ මේ අපිට හිඟයක් තිබෙනවද අපිට අතිරික්තයක් තිබෙනවද කියන එක දැන ගැනීමත් ඒ අනුව හිඟයක් තිබෙනවා නම් හිඟේ නැති කිරීමත් අතිරික්තයක් තියෙනවා අතිරික්තය නැති කිරීමත් එසේ කොට තුලනයක් ඇති කිරීම. එතකොට තුලනයක් ඇති කිරීමෙන් අපිට අවශ්‍ය වන සේවාදායකයන් නිවැරදි සේවක සේවාදායකයන් සංඛ්‍යාවත් ඒ නිවැරදි රැකියාව සඳහා ආය සොයා ගන්නට පුළුවන් යොදා ගන්නට පුළුවන් නිමග්න කරන්නට පුළුවන් Okay then what is the importance of human resource planning what is the importance of human resource planning In other words, there are at least 5 reasons which will necessitate human resource planning to be done for the organization. So what are the 5 reasons? So you can see here. First one, to determine future employee needs. Anagata sevadayaka avashyata thirne kirim, nischay kirim. For the next year, how many employees do we need? After assume for the next 3 years how many employees do we need and then what types of employee do we need so it's first what type of employees will be needed for the next year assume we consider next year and then how many employees relating to each type we will need those things definitely we have to decide in order to decide these things we have to do human resource planning without doing human resource planning we will never be able to determine our future types of employees and also the future number of employees okay then second reason to utilize human resources more efficiently and effectively more efficiently and effectively There are certain HR functions like recruitment, selection. So if you don't have a right human resource plan, we will not be able to do recruitment. We will not be able to do selection. And then we will not be able to do hiring and induction. First, you know, how many employees and what type of employees do we need at least for the next year? We have to decide. Then after deciding, so assume we will need 10 employees as new employees, then we can do recruitment. We can do selection. We can do selection. We can do hiring. So therefore, by doing human resource planning, it is possible to do other HR functions smoothly. Because of smooth performance of other HR functions, of course, the organization will be able to utilize human resources more efficiently and effectively without wasting human resources. By using all the employees to achieve the goals of the organization. That's the meaning of effective utilization. Right. Then reason three, to control employee cost. Of course, if there is a surplus, it is expensive. If there is a shortage, then the organization will not be able to meet customer needs. The customers will get dissatisfied. Because lack of employees serving them, lack of employees serving them. So therefore, having shortages, having surpluses are indeed expensive. Indeed expensive. So if we do human resource planning properly, then we can make sure that there are no surpluses of employees. There are no shortages of employees. Then we will be able to control employee cost. Remember, employee cost is a big component of the total cost of the organization. The ayathaneka samastha piriveya gattot e samastha piriveya itha watina ihila agayak ganna deyak thamai sewadayaka piriveya. E nisa hariyata manava sampath salasum karane sidu kalot sewadayaka athiriktayan sewadayaka hingiyan nathiwanne ne. Ese hingiyan saha athiriktayan nathiwanne naththam aashyamma sewadayaka piriveya hondin palane kirimata ayathaneeta hekiyawa labena. Evagema, you know, also if we do human resource planning properly, we will be able to identify future vacancies. And then if we can identify future vacancies, then from today we can start working to fill those future vacancies. We can make advertisements for all the forecasted, you know, vacancies to be filled. That also will reduce the employee cost. If you don't do human resource planning, අපි මානව සම්පත් සැලසුම් කරන්නේ කරන්නේ නැත්නම් එක එක දවසට එක එක විදිහට කටයුතු කරනවා. දැන් අද අපි හිතමුකෝ අද වේකන්සියක් ඇති වෙනවා. දැන් අද අපි ඒක ඉෂ්ට කරගන්න කටයුතු කරනවා. සමහරවිට මාසයක් දෙකක් යන්න පුළුවන් වේකන්සිය පුරවන්න. ඒතකොට ඒකෙන් වෙන්නේ වියදම් වැඩි වෙන එක. වියදම් වැඩි වෙන එක. නමුත් අපි හරියට මානව සම්පත් සැලසුම් කරන්නේ කරනවා නම් අපිට අපි හිතමුකෝ ලැබෙන මාස 6 සඳහා අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ වේකන්සීස් 6යි. ඒ හය පුරවන්න කියලා එතකොට ඒ හයටම සෙට් වෙන එක ඇඩ්වර්ටයිස්මන්ට් එක අපිට සකස් කරන්න පුළුවන්. So we will be able to prepare only one advertisement to cover all the six vacancies for a period of, you know, for the next 6 months. So then that will definitely reduce the recruitment cost, selection cost. Right. Then the fourth reason necessitating to do the human resource planning, to develop high talent employees like engineers, mission critical employees like engineers, in case of a hospital, medical doctors, in case of a university teachers. So likewise, high talent employees. So to develop high talent employees, there is a lead time. Assume we want to develop a senior manager. Then today we have to have an assistant manager. Then we can train that assistant manager to become a senior manager. But for that training, it will take a considerable amount of time. So that may be 1 year. That may be 2 years. That may be 3 years. Suddenly we can't develop high talent employees, it needs a certain time, 1 year or 2 years. If you take management trainee also, so usually to develop a management trainee to the level of assistant manager, it will take at least 1 year. That's the lead time. That's the lead time. In some high talent employees la develop karanne sulu kaalayak thula karanne ba. Enisa yam kisi kaalayak yana avuruddak avuruddu deyak yana. Enisa apita salasum karanne ena labana avurudu api idamu thawa avurudu dekking apita avashya wenawa managers la. Etoṭa e avurudu dekakin avashya wenna managers la sandaha damma indalama katayutu karanne wenawa. Apita management trainees la kalamana karana abhyasa labin ada indala ganna wenawa. එතකොට එහෙම කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නේ මානව සම්පත් සැලසුම් කරන හරියට සිද්ධ කළොත් පමණයි. Okay then to formulate and implement strategic plans. So what are strategic plans? A strategic plan is a long term plan. A strategic plan is a long-term plan, so that has long-term decisions. So assume we want to start a new factory, that's a strategic decision in a strategic plan. Assume we want to go to international market, and then by going to international market we want to start 3 international markets. That is a long-term decision which is in a strategic plan. So therefore strategic plans are long-term plans. For example, assume we want to start a new factory by the beginning of next year. That new factory needs assume 100 new employees. Then to know how many employees, that is 100. To know that number, to know that type, we have to do human resource planning. So without doing human resource planning, we will not be able to know that right number. Also know that right type. Okay. then activity 5.1. Discuss why some Sri Lankan organizations do not do human resource plan. Singalen kiyoth ei samahara Sri Lankika ayathana Lankave Sangvidhana manava sampath salasum karanne nokaranne. So we learned that at least there are 5 major reasons which will show the importance of human resource planning. So that means we will have to do human resource planning to achieve these objectives. These 5 reasons can be perceived as objectives of human resource planning also, specific objectives of human resource planning. But anyway, surprisingly, there are some organizations in practice, they don't engage in human resource planning. Why? What are the reasons for such organizations not engaging in human resource planning? Right. So our answer is this. So we have given here 5 reasons. First one is lack of understanding about the purposes of human resource plan. So if the relevant manager, top manager, or the owner of the organization doesn't understand these reasons, of course, that owner doesn't have a right attitude about human resource planning. So therefore, that wrong attitude will prevent this owner or this top manager from engaging in or doing human resource planning. Then second reason, non-availability of experts in human resource management within the organization, or inability of procuring such experts to the organization. Again, manav sampat salasum karne kiyana eka sankirna karyayak. The sankirna kiyana eka vruthime karyayak. Samanya pudgalayanta eka ishta karanna ba. Enisa yam kisi poonawak yam kisi adhyapanayak e sandaha awashya wenawa. Etakota manav sampat kamarakana visheshajnin ayathane thula naththam boh welawata manav sampat salasum karne siduwanne ne. Okay, so if there are no human resource experts, at least one human resource expert, then it is not possible to expect doing human resource planning. Right, then attitude that doing human resource planning is unnecessary for organizations in a country like Sri Lanka, as it has a high rate of unemployment. And Sri Lanka visala seva vyukti anupate yatthiyan. Enisat mano sampas salsum karne karande avashya nehi kelagana, anavashya kena akalpediyan. So normally, yes. So if we have many people who are seeking jobs, who are unemployed, then today assume there is a vacancy, then we can advertise for that vacancy. Then tomorrow we are going to have 100 people. Only one vacancy, then tomorrow we are going to have 100 people because there are many people who are seeking jobs. So therefore, there is no need of doing human resource planning. ඒකන අවශ්‍ය වෙලාවේදී ඕනතරම් මිනිස්සු ඉන්නවා ගන්න. That is that is another attitude. But really, do you agree with this? We can't agree with this, at least because of this reason. To determine future, employee needs. So without doing human resource planning, the organization will never be able to determine future employee needs, even though there is a high rate of unemployment. We should know for the next year what type of employees do we need. Then for each type, how many employees do we need, we should decide, even though there is a high rate of unemployment. So therefore, this attitude is a wrong attitude. We cannot accept. Then fourth reason, habit of doing staffing function according to human resource needs which arise on day-to-day basis. So that is another reason. So habit of doing staffing function according to human resource needs which arise on day-to-day basis. Assume today we have a vacancy. Then we are going to fill it. Then assume yesterday or last week we had two vacancies. Then in the last week, we worked to fill those two vacancies. So on day-to-day basis. So that means we don't use proactive approach. We use reactive approach. You must have heard about two approaches to management. One is proactive approach. The other one is reactive approach. What do you mean by proactive approach? Before the problem arises, we anticipate that problem and then we take actions today with that anticipation. So that means before the problem will occur actually, we will go to give a solution for that. That is a proactive approach. But if you take reactive approach, then after the problem occurred, we are going to solve that problem. That is reactive. Remember this one, always proactive approach is better than reactive approach. Well, the proactive approach can purva pratichari pravesi. Reactive approach kila kiyanne pratichari pravesi. Enisa prashnayak the vacancies awata passe hingeyan awata passe atiriktayan awata passe ewa prashnaya hitiyata aragena api ewa visandanna yanawa ewa nathi karanna yanawa. Ethara ehema kramayekata wada api මානව සම්පත් සැලසුම් කරණයෙන් පුරවකතනය කරනවා. අපි අපේක්ෂා කරනවා මෙන්න මේ විදිහේ වේකන්සීස් ඒ අනාගතේ. මෙන්න මේ වගේ සේවාදායකයන් වැඩි සංඛ්‍යාවක් සිටි අනාගතේ. අන්න ඒ අනුව ඒවා නැති කිරීම සඳහා දැන් ඉඳලම කටයුතු කරනවා. So therefore, if you do human resource planning, we are dealing with proactive approach. If you don't do human resource planning, we are dealing with reactive approach. So therefore, proactive approach is recommended under human resource planning, because we don't do planning for the past, we don't do planning for the present. We have to do present time, we don't do planning. Past time, we don't do planning. We will have to do planning for the future. Remember that. So anagate sandaya api salasum karan adha vartamanayata apita salasum karanna ba atheetayata apita salasum karanna ba. Okay, all right. So then our time is very limited, so therefore I am not going to detail these things. So then the habit of doing human resource planning informal. for a short time period, for a month or week. So these are the five reasons we can use for this question, why some Sri Lankan organizations do not do human resource planning. Of course, we are talking about a good organization. Even we can talk about a very good organization. Even we can talk about the best organization in the industry. Of course, these organizations engaging in human resource planning. There are many, many examples of many large multinational organizations which are very serious about human resource planning. Okay, then next, human resource planning process. Mano Sampat Salasum Karna Kriyavali. So under this, you know, we are going to give a good answer for this question. What is this question? How to do human resource planning? How to do human resource planning? For that question, we have attempted to give a good answer for you by using this human resource planning process. That has five steps. Step one, forecast future demand for human resources. Step two, estimate human resource supply. Three, compare forecast demand with the estimated supply. Step four, develop strategies to be taken. Then step five, assess human resource planning effort. Then because of assessment of human resource planning effort, we will have information that will be useful to do these things in future, these steps in future in better way. So therefore, there is feedback. So you can see these arrows, dotted arrow, that is for feedback. Okay, so then you will have to learn this process in detail. Right, let us go to the first step, forecasting demand for human resources. Forecasting demand, you know, in Sinhala we call forecasting, you know, purokatane, bhavi prakashan, purokatane. For anagata mano sampat sandaha bhavi prakashan. So what do you mean by forecasting demand for human resources? That involves estimating the types and numbers of employee needs for future. So they, right. So then, you are very familiar with the, you know, with the demand for a certain product, with the, you know, demand for a certain product in economics. It's a very popular thing, demand for a certain product. But here we are talking about the demand for employees, So therefore, in order to decide the demand for employees, we have to know factors which affect that demand. So that's why we have here factors affecting future demand. So what are the factors which affect future demand? So here we have mentioned here nine factors. So starting with the first one, that is demand for the product. So when the demand for the product will get increased, the demand for the future employees will get increased. So therefore, there is a positive relationship with the demand for the product and the demand for the employees in future. When the demand for the product goes down, then the demand for the future employees also will go down. For example, assume our product, we are producing water machines. At the moment, we are selling 100 units. Assume next year, we have estimated that our demand would be 150 units. Then the 50, you know, there is an increase by 50. Then in order to produce 150 for the next year, we will need additional employees, new employees. Assume we will need 50 new employees, production employees. Then now you can understand that the demand for the product got increased from 100 to 150, and then the demand for the employees will get increased by 15 new employees. Okay, then the second factor that affects the future demand for employees, goals and strategic plans of the organization. Goals and strategic plans of the organization. So assume the company, the organization has decided to start two factories in the next 3 years. These two factories, you know, will need 200 new employees. Because of that strategic plan, the demand for future demand for employees will get increased by 200. Good example. Another, you know, the other side, assume the future will be very bad for a particular organization. Then this organization, you know, has a strategic plan of closing one factory entirely. One factory entirely. That factory has, assume, 100 employees working now, currently working. Because of the strategic decision of closing that factory, then the employee, you know, there will be a reduction. There will be a reduction for the future employees by 100. We will not need 100 employees. By 100, there will be a surplus that we have to avoid. Okay, right, reducing the demand for future employees. Then production methods, nishpadana krame, production methods. So that may be labor intensive. That may be production machine or the capital intensive. So assume manually at the moment we are working. Then we decided to shift from the manual methodology to the automated machines methodology, capital intensive methodology. At the moment, we have 100 employees, but because of shifting from labor intensive to capital intensive, assume we will need only 50 employees. Then by 50, the demand for the future demand for employees will get reduced. Understood? Again, අපි අපි තමු labor intensive මේ කියන්නේ ප්‍රාග්ධන සූක්ෂම ක්‍රමයකට වඩා ශ්‍රමික සූක්ෂම ක්‍රමයක් තමයි දැන් අනුගමනය කරන්නේ. ඒ නිසා laborers ලා වැඩියෙන් ඕනේ. laborers ලා. අපි 100ක් දැන් යොදාගෙන ඉන්නවා. ඒතොර දැන් අපි ඒකෙන් automated ක්‍රමයකට ස්වයංක්‍රීය machinized ක්‍රමයකට අපි යනවනම් capital intensive ක්‍රමයකට යනවනම් අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ භාගයක් විතරයි 50ක් විතරයි. එහෙමනම් ඉතිරි 50 වැඩි වෙනවා. ඉතිරි 50 වැඩි. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ අපගේ තීරණය නිසා shift decision of shifting will reduce the number of employees by 50. Okay, right. Then retirements. Of course, you know, retirements, you know, when the employees, current employees, you know, become matured, and then when they reach the retirement age, that is usually 55 years or 60 years, then they will have to retire. They will have to say goodbye to the organization. Then because of retirements, there will be vacancies increasing future demand for employees. So therefore, definitely, retirements will increase future demand for employees. It will not reduce future demand. Definitely, it will increase future demand for employees. එකන අපි රිටයර්මන්ට්ස් කියලා කියන්නේ විශ්‍රාමයම් නිසා අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම වේකන්සීස් අබෑරතු ඇති වෙනවා. ඒ කියන්නේ විශ්‍රාමයම් මගින් සිදු වෙන්නේ අනාගත ශ්‍රමික ඉල්ලුම, සේවාදායක ඉල්ලුම වැඩි වෙන එක. The resignation, same thing. Resignation. There's a positive relationship between resignations and the future demand for employees. Resignations will increase future demand for employees. So what do you mean by resignations? Due to various reasons, they may be personal, they may be official. You know, there are some employees who resign, who leave the organization before they retire. before they retire. They are called resignations. So resignations will increase vacancies, which will increase future demand for employees. Then deaths, same thing, same relationship. There is a positive relationship between deaths and future demand for employees. The marana nisa vacancies athi eno. Untimely deaths. So nowadays, because of corona, because of serious dangerous diseases, because of accidents, there is a tendency, higher tendency for occurring deaths. We don't expect, deaths, because that is an unpleasant thing. Normally we don't expect that. But anyway, if the number of deaths will get increased, then the demand for future employees will get increased. Then leaves of absence. There are some employees who take leaves of absence for various purposes, especially, for example, if you take female employees who are pregnant, they expect to deliver babies, then they will have to take leaves of absence. Maybe 3 months, maybe another 3 months, 6 months altogether. Then at least for 6 months, there will be vacancies, tentative temporary vacancies, which will increase the demand for temporary employees. There are some employees, who will take study leave, maybe for 2 years. Then for 2 years, they will not be able to come to work. Then they will be on leave, and then there will be tentative temporary vacancies, which will increase temporary demand, future demand, which is temporary, tentative for employees, leaves of absence. එකන සේවකයන් නිවාඩු ගන්නවා නොයෙකුත් හේතු නිසා ඒ අනුව తాවකාලික වශයෙන් ඇබෑර්තු ඇති වෙනවා right then leaves of absence අඩු නම් ඒවා එන්නේ අඩු වෙනවා නම් මොකද වෙන්නේ අනාගත ඉල්ලුම අඩු වෙනවා වැඩි වෙන්නේ නැහැ සේවාදායකින් සඳහා because all the people are working they are not on leave right then the termination what do you mean by termination? There's another word. No. So, okay. Termination, that is, it's not the, termination is not the retirement. It's not the resignation. It's not the death. It's not the leave of absence. It is dismission. So, what is dismission? Again, sevakin, seva dayakya, sevin askarana. නොයෙකුත් හේතු නිසා බොහෝ වෙලාවට විනය විරෝධී වැඩ නිසා විනය විරෝධී දැන් අපේ ලංකාවේ දැන් මේ ඔන්ලයින් ටීචින් නිසා මම මේවා ගැන වැඩි කතා කරන්න කැමති නැහැ these are unpleasant things therefore I don't like to talk about these unnecessary unpleasant indisciplinary things this is online teaching so therefore because of disciplinary reasons there will be a need of dismissing certain employees So assume last year we had to dismiss 10 employees on disciplinary ground. Then there will be 10 vacancies, which will increase the demand for future employees. Right. Then reason 9, external factors such as economic, social and political. External factors, economic factors, social factors, political factors. There are many factors here. All these, are considered as one label, general label, that is external factors. Let us take this one, inflation, for example. Inflation. You know the meaning of inflation. So when inflation gets increased, there will be reduced demand for the product. Assume the company is producing. Because of the reduced demand for the product, there will be reduced need for future employees. So therefore, first, inflation affects the demand for the product, and then that demand for the product will affect the future demand for employees. So therefore, inflation is an indirect factor affecting the future demand for employees. Again, ekapata rijuwama balapana sadhakayak nemeida uddamane wage ekak gattot. Samanyen uddamane nisa bandeyekata thiyena illuma adu wenawa. Ethekota bandeyekata thiyena illuma adu wenakota anagatha sewakayan sadaha thibena illumath adu wenawa. Api upakalpana karana anekut sadhaka ekeni mila ihila giyat anekut sadhaka paribhogaya aadayama janagahana ewa wedi wenna hai kiyala upakalpana karana. Ehema unoth ehema අනිවාර්යෙන් බොහෝ විට අනිවාර්ය නැතත් අපි හිතමු බොහෝ විට බාණ්ඩය සඳහා ඉල්ලුම අඩු වෙලා අනාගත සේවාදායකින් සඳහා ඉල්ලුම අඩු වෙනවා. Then social, you know, political reasons. Because of social functions, you know, there will be a need of producing more and more. Then increasing the future demand for employees. So likewise, please understand. Okay, then activity 5.2 already done, right? Then now let us go to demand forecasting. So these are, you know, what we did so far is factors affecting future demand. So I gave a general understanding about factors affecting future demand. Then now we have to do, you know, after identifying factors affecting future demand, now we have to estimate the impact of each factor on future demand. How do we do that? Through demand forecasting for human resources. Demand forecasting for human resources. So what do you mean by demand forecasting for human resources? So that is estimating future impact of factors affecting human resource demand as much accurate as possible and determining employees needed by the organization for the relevant period of time. So therefore, the one thing is, you know, we have to have a relevant period of time. That may be 1 year, maybe 2 years, maybe 3 years, maybe more than 3 years. At that time horizon for the planning, we must have. And then we have to estimate the impact of all these 9 factors on the demand. Future demand of the employees of the particular organization, you know, particular organization. So the as much accurate as possible. Ekena puluwan taram niravaddivana aakare. Ekena mokada? Remember, forecasting in Sinhala means bhavi prakasha, purokathane. Apita hariyata exactly niveradiwa ita niveradiwa purokathanayak karanna ba. Forecasting is an approximation. Exactly, we can't do anything. We can't do forecasting precisely, accurately. We can't do that. No? So, because future is uncertain. Future is not certain. Even assume the future is certain, but you know, we can't exactly estimate the number of deaths. You can keep the neck. ලබන අවුරුද්ද මැරෙයිද ඊළඟ අවුරුද්ද මැරෙයිද කියලා කියන්න බෑ. ඇක්සිඩන්ට් ඉඳ කී දෙනෙක්, කොරෝනා ඉඳ කී දෙනෙක්, වෙන ලෙඩවල නිසා කී දෙනෙක්, නෝ රෙසිග්නේෂන් කී දෙනෙක් රිසයින් වෙයිද හරියටම කියන්න බෑ. එක්සැක්ට්ලි වී කාන්ට් ඩූ දැට්. අප්‍රොක්සිමේට්ලි වී කැන් එස්ටිමේට්. අප්‍රොක්සිමේට්. දෙර් ආ මෙතඩ්ස් ෆෝ දැට් විච් ඇයි විල් ටීච් ලේටර්. රයිට්. ඕකේ. සෝ දෙර්ෆෝ දෙන් ඇක්චුවලි වෙන් යූ ඩූ ෆෝකාස්ටිං වට් ඩූ යූ ඩූ. So in forecasting, we are going to generate new information, that is future information with regard to a variable. The variable here is human resources, demand for human resources. Ekena vichalyayak sandaha thamai api purokathane karanne. Kisidaka wenas nowana deyak sandaha api purokathane karanne ne. Enisa metana vichalya wenne manava sampada, sewadayaka yana anagatha sewadayakinge pramana wargaya. එතකොට ඒ සම්බන්ධයෙන් අනාගත තොරතුරක් තමයි අපි ජනිත කරන්න යන්නේ. ඒ අනාගත තොරතුර ජනිත කිරීම සඳහා අතීත තොරතුරු අවශ්‍යයි. වර්තමාන තොරතුරු අවශ්‍යයි. So therefore, forecasting involves the use of past information, current information. By using past information and by using current information, We are going to develop future information. That is what we do, forecasting. Right. For that exercise, of course, we have to use what we call techniques of forecasting. What we call techniques of forecasting. Bhavi Prakashana Shilpi Akram, techniques of forecasting. The first one, informal forecast. Informal forecast, this is the easiest way that we can use to do forecasting future demand for human resources. So under this technique, we don't use a systematic base. We don't have. Quickly and randomly we do that. By using intuition or hunch. What is intuition? What is hunch? Hunch is an alternative term to intuition. The intuition kiyala kiyanne api iwa kiyala kiyana. Iwa. Ekena apita dan we have five senses. Normally we have six senses. Six senses. Ekena apita senses varga hayak tiyena. We have two eyes. We have one nose. We have two ears. We have one mouth. And then we have the body. And then we have the mind. So normally we have six senses. Without using these six senses, if you decide something, that decision is based on what we call intuition or hunch. You can gut feeling. Another word is gut feeling. Human resource manager. ලබන අවුරුද්ද සඳහා නිෂ්පාදන සේවකයන් 5 දෙනෙක් ඕන වෙයි කියලා මම කියනවා. පදනමක් නැහැ. සිස්ටමැටික් බේස් එකක් නැහැ. සයන්ටිෆික් බේස් එකක් නැහැ. ක්වික්ලි මම තීරණය කරනවා 5 දෙනෙක් අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා. 5 දෙනෙක් අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා කියලා හිතලා එස්ටිමේට් කරලා 5 දෙනෙක් බඳව ගන්න කටයුතු කරනවා. That's intuition. That's intuition. So normally the information, the estimates based on intuition or hunch are not going to be right. They are usually going to be wrong. So therefore, accuracy of this technique is low. But anyway, it's good for small organizations. Because small organizations cannot afford using experts in human resource management. In small business organizations, there's no, high level of business complexity. Right. Then the second technique, that is formal expert survey. That is formal expert survey. Vidimat Visesajna Samikshani. So under this, systematically, future demand for human resources is estimated by conducting a survey among experts. So here the experts are the people who know, who have figures, who have the information about future demand. For their employees. They may be production supervisors, they may be production managers, they may be department managers, divisional managers. Okay, in a university, they may be heads of departments or deans. Okay, right. So then we have to collect data by using a questionnaire or by using interviews. Then relating to last week lectures. That is about, that was about job analysis. So then we discuss details of the questionnaire method and also interview method. Okay, so then because time is limited, so I'm not going to discuss further. Right. Then one advantage is more accuracy because there are experts involved in the survey. From them, we collect data. But one disadvantage is it takes a longer time. Also, it takes a greater effort in order to prepare a questionnaire, in order to analyze the questionnaire. It needs a greater effort. So that can be considered as a disadvantage. Right. Then third technique, that is Delphi method. In Sinhala, we call Delphi method. Krame. Delphi technique, that's a special kind of expert survey. So under this also we need experts from whom we collect data in order to make estimates about the future demand for human resources. So it's more sophisticated, you know, more complex than the formal expert survey, this one. Here, you know, under this, you know, we can ask, maybe we can develop 5 questions, and then we can, you know, get information by using those 5 questions from certain experts. But here, you know, more systematically we have to do that. So that involves 5 steps according to Professor Stone and Melt. So then these are the 5 steps. Please be serious and learn this method. You know, this is not only useful under human resource management. This will be useful for marketing management or for any, you know, because this is a common method of forecasting. You will have to forecast the future demand for the product. You will have to forecast not only the future demand for human resources. So therefore, this is a general forecasting technique. So be serious and then learn what this is. These are the 5 steps. The first step, an issue, question or problem is identified. What is issue here? Assume, you know, for the next 3 years, what are the types of employees do we need? And then how many employees, you know, we will have to hire for the next 3 years? That's the issue. That's the problem. Okay, then second step, a small group or panel of 10 or fewer experts is identified. So normally five experts or maximum 10, small group. Because experts know much, so therefore it is difficult to get an agreement. විශේෂඥින් වැඩියෙන් දන්න හින්දා හරි අමාරුයි මේ එකඟත්වයකට එන්න යම් කිසි දෙයක. ඒ නිසා තමයි සාමාන්‍යයෙන් සංඛ්‍යාව අඩු කරන්න කියන්නේ. Okay, so then independent judgments about the issue are obtained from each expert through a questionnaire or structured interview. Independent judgment, because they are experts, they can, you know, they can decide how many employees needed, what types of employees needed or will be needed for the next 3 years. They can decide because they are experts. They don't need the support of others because they know. So the swadhina vinishya tamai balaparathi. Not through discussion. They don't make estimates through discussion. There's no teamwork here. Okay, there's no teamwork here. Independently, each expert has to contribute. Okay, then step 4, an intermediary or facilitator collects, analyzes and feeds back information from the first questionnaire or interview to each expert. The intermediary normally here is the human resource manager, who is responsible for doing a human resource plan for the next 3 years. That is intermediary. Maybe assistant human resource manager who has been entrusted by the human resource manager to do this work of human resource planning. Right. Either e pudgalaya thamai me facilitator, eya thamai intermediary, eya thamai then me collects, doing data collection, it was analyzing that set of data and then feeding back. Because the feedback, you know, then toraturu aposarayak e expert lada dena. Steps 3 and 4 are repeated until there's a consensus on the issue or problem. Samane palamu vate ekagatwayak enne naha mokada me gola visheshajnyo nisa. Itawas aapahu devuni vate ekata yanna puluwan. තව සමහරට තුන්වෙනි වටේ සෝරි ඔව් තුන්වෙනි වටේ සව හතර හතරවෙනි වටේ එහිම එම යන්න සිද්ධ වෙනවා ගොඩාක් ඉතින් වට යන්නේ නැහැ කාලය because of the time problem because of the effort problem maybe usually 5 rounds maximum then you know at the end of the 5th round we will develop the estimate for the future demand so therefore the forecast is based on expert consensus experts agreement. So therefore, the degree of accuracy of this technique is relatively higher. Though it is not possible to get 100% consensus among the forecast done by the expert, an approximate agreement is expected. So remember that. Okay, go to this example. You will be able to understand further. this technique. Be serious. Have a serious look at this table. An example of forecasting by Delphi technique. Here we have, you know, my left side round column, first round, second round, third round. Then he expert A, expert B, expert C, expert D, expert E. So there are five experts in this Delphi panel. You know, they are called Delphi panel, this group is. Right, then assume the problem is for the next 3 years, how many production employees, you know, will we need for the next 3 years? And then that question, so assume I am the human resource manager. Who does that human resource planning? Then I give that question to this expert A. He answered in this way. What is this way? 33. Then expert B answered 45. Then expert C answered 50. So according to expert C, then 50 employees will be needed for the next 3 years. So these are production employees, assume. Production employees. Right. Then according to expert D, that is the number is 40. Expert, according to expert E, the number is 60. And then you can see, you know, examine. Now my question is, right, is there a consensus or an agreement among these five experts with regard to the number of production employees? Of course, there is no. Ekena metana ekangathwayak nenne. The expert la pas dena anka pahak kiyala thiyen. Ekinekata wenas anka paha. Ekangathwayak nenne. There is no approximate agreement also. There is no. Asanna wasen api hitamu 33 35 30 and e wage thibuna. There is an approximate agreement. Then, you know, what we have to do is now I am the facilitator. So then I will get these numbers. Then I will do a certain analysis, usually by using descriptive statistics. So you know what descriptive statistics, especially mean, standard deviation, then the range. Those, you know, statistics are needed. So what is range? That is the difference between the maximum number and the minimum number. The methana range kiwathe the maximum number ekak 60 minimum number ekak 33 thora 33 60 yata 60 33 in sorry 33 60 in adu karama range ekena the mean ekak ganan balanna hati dannawa you know how to calculate mean 30 33 plus 45 plus 50 plus 40 plus 60 then the total we have to divide by 5 because there are only 5 experts here. And then we will be able to get that arithmetic mean. Okay, so like, then A toroturu tika mewa karala, then again, you know, I send that analysis, you know, that analysis to all these 5 experts. At the second round, then requesting again, please do. Thank you for helping us in making this human resource plan. So therefore, this is the second round. So please do. By considering the information supply. Statistics, first round, analyze. So then you consider. The experts, you know, will really consider them also. Then they will rethink. They will rethink and then they will do re-estimating. And then at the second round, assume we got these results. According to expert A, 38. Then according to expert B, 42. So likewise. Right. Here in this round also, at the second round also, you can understand that there is no approximate agreement. Then again, we do the analysis. Then we provide the results of the analysis to the relevant experts and then request again to engage in re-estimating. For the third time, that is third round. So assume these are the results of the third round. Expert A gave 40, then expert B 41, then expert C 42, expert D 42, then expert E 45. Then here, you know, grossly you can see there is an approximate agreement. There is an approximate agreement, then you can stop. This exercise, and then you can get the mean value, that is 42. That is considered as the final estimate. That is the number of production employees the organization will need for the next 3 years, 42. All right? Okay, then shall we go to fourth step, unit forecasting. This is a broad approach for human resource forecasting. So this involves the use of bottom-up approach. Again, pallaya indala udata yana praveshayak thiyen. You know, in an organization, there are many units. There are many departments. So unit-wise, then department-wise, then organization-wise, we can make estimates. That's the meaning of unit forecasting. So then look at this example. This is an example relating to a university setting. Unit forecasting in City University of Ceylon. In a university, you know, this, you know, department, you know. So there are departments, academic departments. So even you are aware about our faculty. The faculty has several departments like HR department, accounting department, finance department. So likewise. So therefore, so according to this method, the each head is required to do a forecast of academics. How many academics, how many lecturers will be needed for the next 3 years. So by considering factors affecting future demand for academics, resignations, leaves of absence, deaths, terminations, then the demand for the service, that is education, then the economic situations of the country, social situations of the country, so likewise. So these factors will be taken into consideration, and then each head thus, you know, preparing the relevant forecast for the relevant department. Then each head has to submit his or her forecast to the dean. That means the superior of the head. Then the dean will get a forecast from heads. Assume there are five heads. Then the dean will get forecast from five heads. Then the dean will have to do an examination, study. And then dean, you know, can prepare a general forecast for the entire faculty by usually combining the forecast given by the each head, maybe without adjustments or with adjustments. And then each dean is required to forward his or her faculty forecast to the vice chancellor. And the vice chancellor is finally responsible for preparing the final, the total human resource plan for the entire university for the next 3 years. Okay, likewise, in a business organization also, we can go like this. Right. One advantage, major advantage is this. There is the involvement of all the unit heads of the organization in forecasting. Then there is participation. Because of that, accuracy of the forecasting is higher, because normally these down people, down managers, they are more aware about their employee needs. Therefore, they can give accurate figures. Then the plans will be more accurate. That's a major advantage. But major disadvantage, of course, it takes a longer time to complete the forecast, because each unit head or department head involves in forecasting. Right. Then shall we go to next one? Extrapolation. In Sinhala, prakshepane. So what do you mean by extrapolation? According to Professor Werther and Professor Davis, so it involves extending past rates of change into the future. Extending. So normally, when we do forecasting, we have to use past data. Also, we have to use present data. Then past data, based on past data, the planner is supposed to identify a certain pattern, generate a certain pattern or certain trend. That trend, you know, what is the trend? Trend is something that's a pattern which will, you know, which is expected to continue into the future. So therefore, based on the pattern, we develop the forecast. So this is a simple approach and also is easy to use. However, the forecast may not be accurate because it doesn't consider many factors affecting demand. That's a major disadvantage. But to calculate, it is simple, easy to use. Okay, go to this example. Dia Tire Company is a growing manufacturing firm that utilized production employees during the past 5 years as follows. The Aurudu Paakthina, Didas Dhana Mendala, Didas Dhatra Dakwa, for a number of production employees, A Aurudu Bhavitakala, Yodagat Seva Daikin Sankhya, production employees, Menami again Yuttai. Right, then there had been a continuous increase of production employees for the past 5 years. Then Didas Dhatra Belluhama, you can see that's a continuous improvement from 351 to 410. That's a continuous increase of production employees. Right. Then the company expects further growing. So how many production employees does it need to increase for the next year, 2017, not 2017, now 2020. Okay, we can take 2020. So okay, next year. We are in 2019 as well. Or even 2001. Don't worry, for the next year. Right, then it is possible to calculate the mean of changes, added employees here. Mean, you know, the mean, I mean, the changes we can calculate from 30. Again, Tunsiya Pana Indala, Tunsiya Hetatara Dakwa Vinasagan. It was a Tunsiya Hetatara Indala, Tunsiya Asu Dakwa Vinasagan. It was Tunsiya Asu Indala, Tunsiya Anuhatara Dakwa Vinasagan. Change between the two numbers. Then we can total these changes. Because here there are five numbers, then of course change numbers. The numbers for change should be four. And then we have to total those four numbers and then we have to divide by five. Or four. Okay, we can divide by four. No problem. Because four, right. Then with regard to the number of production employees utilized for the past 5 years. Then the changes for the past years are these. Okay, so then here the my this one from 14. Okay, so there's a mistake. So don't worry about because this mistake doesn't hurt your meaning, your understanding. Right. The mean value, the mean of the values is 14.75, approximately 15. Then this 15, you know, this number we can consider as the number of new production employees to be hired for the next year. There is another way, another simple way. Simply we can take, you know, we can total up these and then get the mean value. That is also possible. Right. Then number 6, the technique numbered 6, indexation, Darshaka Karani in single. So here we have to develop a ratio between two numbers. Definitely one number should be relating to the number of employees. Number of employees. The another number should be a causal factor. Ekena sahetu ekena hetu karana hetu karakayak hoya ganna. Metana dan anupathayak ne hadanne yanne. Etokota sadaka deka thiyenawa. Ekak tama hetu karaka sadaka. Ekena anith sadake tamai sevaka sankhyawa. Etokota sevaka sankhyawata balapanu labana sadakayak ganna. According to Professor Desleck, so you can see sales volume. You can see sales volume, that is the causal factor. That is the factor that affects the future demand. So that's the number of future number of employees required. And then here the number of employees, the example is, according to Professor Desleck, the number of sales people. So assume that a firm could make 10 million in sales in the last year by utilizing 10 sales persons. Now we can calculate a ratio based on this sentence. Then the ratio is 1 million to 1. 1 million to 1. So it indicates that the organization, this firm, needs one sales person to generate a sales the value of which is 1 million. ඒ කියන්නේ ලක්ෂ 100ක් නේද මිලියන් 10ක් මිලියන් 10ක් ජනිත කිරීම සඳහා සේවකයෝ 10 දෙනෙක් යොදා ගන්න. එතකොට 1 මිලියනයක් ජනිත කරන්න 1 සේවකයෙක් අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා. එතකොට අපි හිතමු estimate කරනවා ඊළඟ අවුරුද්දේදී for the next year sales. So if the next year sales forecast is 20 million 20ක් නා the firm will need to hire 10 additional sales person for the next year. Easy to understand. Another example, a university uses a students teacher ratio that is 15 to 1 in hiring academics. What does this mean? So that means one teacher, one university teacher will be needed for a number of 15 students. So if the university increases its students for the next year by 30, then it will need to hire 2 academics. For 15, 1, and for the rest, 15, another 1. Then 2 new academics will have to be hired. Okay? Right. So this method also is a simple method, and also it is easy for us to calculate. However, it doesn't consider some important factors, you know. So these are mathematical things. Usually the mathematical things do not consider many factors in the reality. So that's why some practicing managers, usually they don't use these techniques. But if they use this technique and this one, they will use other techniques also. While using other techniques, they will use these techniques, you know, as supportive techniques. Right. Okay, then activity 5.3, that is about discussing the meaning, major advantage and major disadvantage of each of the above techniques, that was done. Okay, right. Then forecasting translates. Now we considered factors affecting the future demand, and then we utilized by use, you know, we can use various techniques of forecasting. Maybe one technique, maybe two techniques, maybe three techniques. Okay, depending on our time, our effort, our knowledge. Okay, then, right. So then, we got, you know, certain numbers, certain statements. So now, you know, the forecasting translates the factors of demand into short-term and long-term statements of employee needs. Short-term statements. Then short-term needs are more specific compared with long-term needs. So then by using short-term needs, we are supposed to prepare a table that is called staffing table or manning table. Piriskarna vaguva kadanno. This table lists the future vacancies for each type of jobs considered. Then long term statements gattama samane by numbers walin denne. So api mehema kiyanne samane labana avurudu paha sandaha apita me wage seva daayakin pramanayak avashya wei. Vidyanjin apita yam pramanayak avashya wei. Mokada api balaprathana aluthin nishpadanayan kirimata. You know, so likewise, you know, but exactly the number we don't have. But in case of short term, the type exactly we will have, and also the number for each type exactly we will have. So therefore, short term needs are more specific. That can be reported in a table, what is called staffing table or manning table. Right, activity 5.4, construct a hypothetical staffing table. So now you can see that hypothetical partial staffing table for a period of 1 year. So normally remember, you know, staffing table gives a short-term human resource plan that specifies job vacancies for the period of 1 year. Month-wise, we can specify. So you can see here, job vacancies by months of the year. Then from January to December, these are months of the year. January, February, March, so likewise, November, December. Then here you can see total, the total number. So here you can see the job number. Normally in a good organization, there is a number given for every job. There's a number given for every job. So let me describe this one, O. O03. So here the O stands for operations. Then 03, that is the job which got the number 03. So then by title, it is Assistance Operations Manager. That's the job title. And then we, you know, that job is located in a department, that is manufacturing department. So here we have the department, manufacturing. And then you can see one vacancy will occur in the month, that is March, will occur in the month March, one vacancy. Then the reason for that vacancy here, you know, has been given. That is resignation, under remarks, resignation. So because of resignation, one vacancy will occur in March, and then there are no other vacancies which will occur in other months. So therefore only, you know, one. So therefore the total is one. Okay, so then if you go to this one, then 07, the job title is production supervisor, the department is manufacturing. Then one vacancy will occur in January, another vacancy will occur in July. The reason for occurring these two vacancies is expansion, Okay, so likewise you can see here, these are financial department jobs. Then we have here marketing department's jobs, two jobs here, which are in marketing department. Then we have here two jobs which are in human resource department, HR executive, HR assistant. And then here we have two jobs, namely driver and security guard, which are in administrative department. So then you can see the reasons, expansion, retirement, expansion. So likewise, leave of absence, this one. So these are indeed some of the factors which affect the future demand for employees. So therefore you can see total job vacancies, you know. So I have not given that by number. So therefore you can get the total here. The, you know, there can be other. So these blanks mean, you know, other possible job vacancies in reality. Okay, all right. So therefore, I think that you understood a hypothetical partial staffing table, especially in case of the government. You know, the need of preparing a staffing table is more. So if you take Ministry of Public Administration, then there are so many departments. So then, you know, for one year there will be many vacancies. In case of a small organization, then we will have a short table. In a medium size, somewhat larger. So therefore, what is staffing table or manning table? That is a short-term human resource plan that specifies the number of job vacancies and the types of job vacancies which will occur, usually within a period of 1 year. Okay, all right. Then shall we go to the next step of our process of human resource planning? That is second step, estimating human resource supply. So there are two sources of supply. When we think of HR supply, there are two sources. One is internal source, the other one is external source. Internal source and external source. So this is supply of human resources. There are two sources, external one, and the external one. External one, at least there are two. There are two employees who are working for other companies, or other firms, Then also there are people, you know, job seekers. So they are in the labor markets. They are the people who are seeking jobs. You know, they are the people who are seeking jobs. So then job seekers come under external supply. Employees who are working, they are not job seekers, but sorry, they are also job seekers, but they are working for other companies. So that's why we have employees, but they seek better jobs. They seek better jobs. They are not happy with the current jobs. Maybe they are happy, but they want to get, you know, they want to get jobs of higher ranks. But for the organizations where they are working, there are no job vacancies. Therefore, they want to apply for job vacancies of our company. You know, so I am discussing this from the view of our company. So therefore, for our company, the supply of human resources has two sources. One is internal, the other one is external. So then internal, so who are the internal? So internal are the current employees. Current employees who are working for our company, So these current employees can be utilized to promote in order to fill job vacancies. Assume we have 50 job vacancies, then maybe by using current employees, we can fill 15 employees. I mean, we can fill 15 job vacancies. Then 35, you know, still there are 35 job vacancies to be filled. In order to fill those job vacancies, we have to use this external source of human resource supply. Okay, right. So therefore, I want to make this point, as far as this process, this second step of the process of human resource planning is concerned, we don't focus on this. We focus on this. So therefore, we are now considering internal supply. Right, so estimating human resource supply involves making internal supply estimates. So this step has two sub steps. The first one, auditing current human resources. The second one, deciding replacements. Okay, that means identify and arrange possible replacements. Another word, succession planning. Right. So you are supposed to learn in detail each sub step. Okay, let me detail. Now the sub step one, auditing current human resources. This is not that financial audit. Maybe you are familiar with financial audits, audits of accounting reports. They are usually done by so-called auditors, you know, to ensure that there is, you know, the audit accounting reports have true and fair view. But that is not, you know, here it is not that auditing. Here the meaning of auditing is assessing characteristics of current workforce. So therefore the HR auditing summarizes each employee's competency, knowledge, skills and abilities. So if you do successfully HR audit, then there will be two documents. One is skill inventories, the other one is management inventories. So if you take a skill inventory, you know, an inventory is something that catalogs competencies of employees. So in fact, an inventory is an official document that catalogs competencies of a certain employee. One inventory for one employee we can prepare, or for 10 employees we can prepare one master inventory, no problem. Right. So this enables the planner to have a comprehensive understanding in respect of the capabilities, knowledge, skills and abilities of the current employees, you know, who are within the organization. They can be transferred, they can be promoted to fill vacancies, to fill vacancies. Right. Then the activity 5.5, discuss the difference between skills inventory and management inventory. The inventories for the Degatina, Kusalata inventories, Kalamanakarna inventories, management inventories. So what's the difference between the two? Right. If you take a skill inventory, in simple, skill inventories are for non-managerial employees. Management inventories are for managerial employees. That's the difference. Then if you take a skill inventory, so that should contain the following types of information. Identification information of the employee, name, address, age, you know, gender, all this. Then identification information of the job, current job title, job locations, likewise. Then education, academic and professional. Then experiences, including previous jobs held. Then seniority. What is seniority? Jeshthatava. Jeshthatava kiyala ekak thiyena. Api passe me gana deerghawa katha karana anagatha maatrukawada. Seniority. Seniority. Then special competencies. Then training. Current and past job performance evaluations. Promotability. What is promotability? Whether, you know, so assume we prepare one, you know, there is a clerk whose name is Nimal. And then for Nimal, we prepare a skill inventory. And then, what is the meaning of promotability in this inventory context? Whether this Nimal can be promoted to a job of higher rank or cannot. That's the meaning of promotability. Again, Nimal kina putgalaya. උසස් කරන්න පුළුවන්ද බැරිද? That is promotability. උසස් කළ හැකි බව. Then weaknesses of that person. Then preferences of that person. Okay, so then these types of information can be seen in a skill inventory. So in addition to these types of information, in a management inventory, you can find additional types of information. So then the number of subordinate supervisors. The manager can expand the management inventory acting. If the manager can put in subordinates, the number of subordinate supervisors. Then jobs and duties of the subordinates. Then you can normal employee can put a non-manager employee can put a skill inventory. If you have a normal employee can put a subordinates, you know, manager is a person who has a set of subordinates to be managed. Okay, that's why we call manager, right? So manager, normally you have learned that. What is the meaning of management? There's a classic definition for the meaning of management. Management is getting done through, getting things done through other people and with people. Isa noyikut devala pita karogan yuna minisun sambal, minisun margi. Now that's the, you know, then the person who does, you know, getting things done through other people is called manager. Therefore, number of subordinate supervisors, jobs and duties of the subordinates, then the total budget. You can have a manager, you know, budget, which is a department manager. There's a budget for the department. That budget, the manager is required to manage. Then management training received. The manager can go to the management training. The management systems develop and implemented. Then a manager knows good systems develop. Then if you take human resource manage, you know, various HR systems like training systems, disciplinary systems, performance evaluation systems. Right. Then the creative work and innovations are these things. Okay. So go to, now I wish to draw your attention to this exhibit point 5.3. That gives an example of management inventory. So this was prepared based on an actual manager who is working as human resource manager in a company. in a large company, yes. Okay, then management trainee. MM Kumar, that's the name. Management inventory. Then the employee number, then the present job title, then the location. Then you can see education. BSc HR from Jaipur with second class upper honors. Then we MSc Management from Jaipur, specializing in HR. Then you can see experience here. Executive training from 2000 to 2001. Then you can see executive HR at ABC company from 2001 to so likewise. Then assistant HR manager at another company, you know. Then I have, you know, I have changed, I have disguised the actual names of the organization. Then human resource manager at NN Firm Limited from 2007 up to now. Then special managerial trainings, this manager received. Internship in HR and then disciplinary management 2005, then counseling in 2007. And you can see seven competencies as far as this manager is concerned. Then the superior rating, you know, how this manager is rated by, you know, his or her superior. 5, 4, 4, 4. Then 5 stands for excellent. So this means what? You know, this manager, who is manager by name? MM Kumar. So MM Kumar's technical competence is excellent according to superior rating. That's the meaning. Then Kumar's human relation competence is not excellent because it is 4. So that means it is good. So 4 stands for good. 3 stands for average, moderate. 2 stands for poor. 1 stands for very poor. Okay, right. Then language skills of this manager. Superior rating, you know. So like English, Sinhala. Then hobbies. Then you can see position preference. HRM, training and development, industry relations. The main manager, Kemathi, Vedakaran Kemathi, Dharan Kemathi, Tanaturutamai, and me, answer. Then subordinates, 2 assistant HR managers. Then the total budget managed, 8 million. Okay, right. Then the relevant employee signature and the relevant superior signature. Then the HR department, date. Okay, right. Now shall we go to second step of the, sorry, second sub step of the second step of our process of human resource planning. Right. That is to identify and arrange possible replacement. Alternatively, succession planning. Then in single in possible again replacements can anagata again. Replacements can prati stapane in single. Succession kilakane anuprapti. Anuprapti salasum karani. Again ekkenik natuina kut ilangarene ekkenakav. එක්කෙනෙක් නැතිවීම නිසා එක්කෙනෙක් ඉවත් වීම නිසා ඇතිවන වේකන්සිය පිරවීම සඳහා ඊළඟට යෝග්‍යතම පුද්ගලයා සුදුස්ස අනුප්‍රාප්තිකය සක්සස් so therefore succession planning is that so then through the audit the human resource planner receives information then this information will enable that human resource planner to assign specific employees internal employees to fill future vacancies. So these tentative assignments can be recorded on replacement charts. This is another technical term that you have to learn. Replacement charts kila jati atti hai. Ewa game replacement summaries kila jati atti hai. Prati sthapana saarans hai. Megan api velana tinisa vedi kata karanne namut replacement charts. Prati sthapana satahan, you should know, you should have a good understanding about them. So then activity 5.6, that is about constructing a hypothetical replacement chart. Okay, so this is a hypothetical partial replacement chart. So what is this partial? Partial kila kyanne, समस्त अग्नि में अंश्या यानी एक कोटसा पाश अर्धवासी यानी गुड़ाक कलवना करो सीट न तैनाक अभी मितने मसाला का बाला ने मैनेजर्स ला पास देने के मितने ही नहीं ओके सो दैट्स व्हाई इट्स पाश पासर्स रिप्लेसमेंट चा सो वी हैव हियर जनरल मैनेजर देन हियर वी हैव ऑपरेशंस मैनेजर देन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजर देन मार्केटिंग मैनेजर फाइनेंस मैनेजर हैव अ लुक सीरियस लुक एट दिस वन Okay, so then here you can see A. Pereira. That is the name of the current general manager. Then within bracket, the age of that manager has been given, 54. Then here you can see operations manager, A. Ashok. Then whose age is 50. Then here human resource manager, the current name of the name of the current human resource manager is N. Nimal. Whose age is 42. Then marketing manager, the name of the current person is P. Kamal, whose age is 40. Then here the finance manager, the name of the current person working as the finance manager is K. Janaki, whose age is 35. Okay, so therefore here we can see A stand for age, E stands for experience in present job, then T, total experience with the firm. Then this one, PP, stand for promotion potential. So these are the keys, you know, with which you should be familiar in constructing a replacement chart. So then, you know, this check mark or the correct one stand for ready now for promotion. Then plus means needs more training, exposure. Then X, this one, multiple mark. It means, you know, not suitable for promotion. Then we have here JP, that is stands for job performance. A, excellent. B, good. Likewise. Okay, so then, now, okay, I'll draw your attention. Listen to me. Here we have general manager. So assume, by the end of this year, this current person who is A. Pereira, is going to retire. Then by the end of this year, there will be a vacancy for the post general manager. That vacancy we will have to fill. That means we have to find out a possible right replacement for A. Pereira. Okay, so then successor, in other words, we have to find out a successor. Then general manager retire in one year. Itawara general manager post take vacancy at Vena. Itawara general manager Sanda api anupraptiki. Swagatayati. I swagan internally. We find a person internally. Because this step is concerned with internal supply of human resources, not external supply of human resources. Internally. That also please understand. Okay, right. Then you can see here who is the successor? Green color. A. Ashok. A. Ashok. So this checking mark, you know, correct mark. What is that? Ready now for promotion. But this person in Nimali needs more experience. Kamal, not suitable. Sorry. Yes, needs more experience. Plus, no. So then, Janaki, not suitable for promotion. And then, this is the person who is suitable. So then, by name, that person is A. Ashok. Who is the current operations manager? Therefore, to fill the vacancy for the post of general manager, we have decided, the plan has decided, to use or utilize A. Ashok, who is the current operations manager. Understood? This is the success for this post. So therefore, a partial replacement chart is a figure that will tell us who is going to be replaced by another person. I mean, whom, you know, at the event of a vacancy, who is going to be replaced? That is shown by a replacement chart. Right, now for the operation manager, because A. Ashoka has been decided to be promoted to this post by the beginning of next year. Then there will be a vacancy for this job. Then to fill this vacancy, who is the successor? So according to this, J. Janaka. So assume Janaka, you know, these are assistant operations managers. Okay, so from four assistant operation managers, Janaka is the right person, right replacement. All right. Okay. Then shall we go to the next step? That is the third step of our process. That is about comparing forecast demand with estimated supply. Forecast demand with estimated supply. So this step involves determining net employee requirement. Net employee requirements, Suddha Sevadayaka Avashyata, and identifying shortages and surpluses of human resources. So then, according to Activity 5.7, we are supposed to construct a hypothetical net employee requirements table that has been given here. Now you can see in Table 5.5, calculation of net employee requirements. So you can see job title here, then the job number, then the forecast demand, estimated supply, then net employee requirements. Okay, you take this one, assistant operations manager, then the forecast demand is 1, estimated supply is 0. What does it mean? The net employee requirement is minus 1. Minus means a shortage. Plus means a surplus. So here the minus, then there's a shortage. That means further, there is no internal person who is a suitable person who can be utilized to fill this vacancy. Assistant operations manager. Therefore, the assistant operations manager කියන රැකියාව ගත්තොත් පුරෝකතනය කරන ලද ඉල්ලුම වෙන්නේ එකයි. ඒ කියන්නේ අභ්‍යර්ථු එකක් ඇති වෙනවා කියලා හිතනවා. අපි ඊතම ලබන අවුරුද්දට. ඒක estimated supply එක internally කවුරුවත් නැහැ. ඒ කියන්නේ internally සුදුසුකම් තියෙන පුද්ගලයෙක් නැහැ අතලදී. එහෙම කෙනෙක් හිටියා නම් එයා මාරු කරලා හරි උසස් කරලා හරි මේ අභ්‍යර්ථු පුරවන්න තිබුණා. සාමාන්‍යයෙන් උසස් කරලා. පල්ලෙහා එක්කෙනෙක් යොදා ගන්නකොට. හරි. ඒ නිසා දැන් මෙහෙම ඉන්ටර්නල් කෙනෙක් නැති නිසා තමයි මෙතන කියන්නේ net employee සුද්ධ සේවාදායක අවශ්‍යතාවය එකයි කිය. ඒ කියන්නේ පිටින් අපිට ගන්න සිද්ධ වෙනවා. shortage එකක් තියෙනවා එකක්. එතකොට මේක fill කරන්න we have to take a right person from outside. From outside. Not from, you know, not from within the organization. Okay, then if you take the second job, production supervisor, then you can see forecast demand is 2. Then estimated supply also 2. Then net employee requirement is 0. So that means the vacancy deka athi una, vacancy deka ape inna seva dayakinge purogatta replacement thiyena. Enisa net employee requirement eka binduwa. There is no surplus, there is no shortage with regard to this job, production supervisor. Okay, all right. Then if you take this one, go to this one, driver. Estimated demand is 1. Estimated demand is 1. But the estimated supply is 0. So that means what? Driver, no? Right. I started with drivers, right. Okay, estimated forecast demand is 1. Then the estimated supply is 3. Again, අපිට අනාගතයේ ලැබන අවුරුද්ද අවශ්‍ය වෙන එක ඩ්‍රයිවර් කෙනෙක්. නමුත් ඉන්නෝ ඩ්‍රයිවර්ස්ලා 3 දෙනෙක්. ඒ කියන්නේ දෙන්නෙක් වැඩි. That's why plus 2. Plus 2. There's a surplus. අද මේ surplus එක we have to reduce. We have to remove. This shortage we have to remove. That is what we do under fourth step. That is about developing strategies. developing strategies. So then strategies in surplus conditions. Strategies in surplus conditions. එකනේ සේවාදායකයෝ වැඩි වෙනකොට අපිට අපේ ආයතනේ දැන් සලකා බලන ආයතනේ සේවාදායකයෝ වැඩි කියලා අපි අස්තමේන්තු කර. ආ මොනවද කරන්න පුළුවන්? මොන වගේ උපක්‍රමද අපිට ගන්න පුළුවන්? මොකද වැඩිෙන් තියාගන්න බෑ. That is very costly. That is not what is expected from good HR, especially from this function, sound human resource planning. If you do sound human resource planning, we should not have surplus conditions. Right. First strategy is hiring freeze. ekena navatha aluthen ganneka nathara karunu hiring freeze. Freeze kiyala kiyanne nawatta hiring freeze. Da aluthen ganne nathi unahama issarahata enne naha aluthen sewaka. Namuth metana madaka thiyaganna you know meka nathara karai kiyala surplus ekak nathi wenne. Assume you know surplus. You know we have 10 employees who are in excess. Sevakayo 10 denek wedi. Etawata by following this strategy, we can't get rid of that number. Still we have you know those excessive 10 employees. So therefore, then remember this. We have to follow this one in addition to following this strategy. You have to follow another one. To remove the surplus. එනිසා ඒක නිසා surplus එක නැති වෙන්නේ නැහැ. අනාගතයේදී වැඩි වෙන surplus එකයි නතර වෙන්නේ. එනිසා මේකට අමතරව තව උපක්‍රමයක් ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන්න වෙනවා. මේ දක්වලා තියෙන ඒ වලින් එකක්. අඩු වශයෙන් එකක්. Right. Then attrition. That is voluntary departures. ඒ කියන්නේ කැමැත්තෙන් වෙන් වෙලා යන attrition. Resign වෙනවා. Then inca you know අපි කියන ඕගොල්ලෝ අපිට වැඩි ඒ නිසා කැමති නැව ඕගොල්ලෝ ඉවත් වෙලා යන්න you know so unwillingly without pleasure you know we have to tell them you know assume you are in excess then I am the relevant manager you are the employee who is in excess then I have to tell you sorry you know I have you know you are not needed so then please you know leave this organization attrition voluntary departures abe metana kemathin kema samalaata mama kiyenakan innae you know you decide I don't force really then encouragement of leaves of absence niwaadu yanna kiyana samalaata thavakaaliyako thamai shortage sorry surplus ekak thiyenne abe thun surplus ekak thiyenne maasa 6 ekata ayemana apita kiyanna puluwan females employees la 6 denek inna abe e 6 denata kiyana niwaadu yanna kiyala encouragement of leaves of absence aapa uganna ita pass right so then early retirement on voluntary basis kemathin retire wenna kiyala kiyana then reduction of reward expenditure da api ayin karanne nathuwa dan meke yawilla ayin karanne sevakaya wedipura sevakaya 10 denek innawa nan ayin karanne namuth dena deemana adu karana samareeta amatharawa api ithuma dunnai kiyala bonus dunnai kiyala bonus nathi karana reduction of reward expenditure බොහෝ සේවාදායක දැන් විශේෂයෙන් දැන් මේ කොරෝනා වගේ තත්ත්වයකදී දැන් ඔයගොල්ලෝ දැනගන්න ඕනේ සමහර ආයතන පඩි අඩු කරලා තියෙනවා. දැන් මොකද දැන් බිස්නස් අඩු වෙලා තියෙනවා. එතකොට අතිරික්තයක් තියෙන සේවකයන්ගේ. අපිදම සේවකයෝ 5 දිනක් වැඩි. නමුත් ඒ 5 දිනාට යන්න කියන්නේ නැහැ. මොකද ඒගොල්ලෝ ගොඩක් මාංශල වැඩ කරපු අය කියලා අපි හිතමු. You know if you consider corona situation normally in Sri Lanka not only in Sri Lanka in the world there are organizations you know which did cutting various rewards given to their employees because of reduced businesses you know there are some employees who are in excess so surpluses rather than you know asking them to leave rather than asking them to retire early on voluntary basis the organization will keep them however bonuses you know other you know welfare facilities they can be reduced etoda company eta viyadama palane karaganna puluwa I think you can understand then the layoff what is layoff this is a temporary stoppage of the service of the employee you know if you do layoff There is an intention of taking the person back when the situation will be okay. ඒකෙන් දැන් මේ වගේ කොරෝනා තත්ත්වයක අපි දන්නේ නැහැ සමහර ආයතනවල ලේ ඔෆ් කරන්න වෙනවා. තාවකාලිකව නතර කරන්න වෙනවා. අපි දුමු මාස 6කට නතර කරන්න වෙනවා. ආපහු මාස 6 ගියාට පස්සේ තත්ත්වය හොඳ වුණාම ආපහු ගන්න. Lay off. That is not a good thing. But anyway, it's not a pleasant thing because the person becomes jobless. But anyway, you know, the company has to survive. Company has to survive. The abhidhamuka mehema sevakyo ayin karanne nathuwa company eka digatama thiyagattot company eka wahenna puluwa. Etakota company inna nan sevakyo 100ak 100 denatama rassa nathi wenna puluwa. Ita wada hondai 10 denekuta thavakaliko nawaththana eka 10 denek. අනිත් 90 දෙනාට හරි රැකියාව තියෙනවා ඒක. You know the majority we have to think of the well being of the majority not the well being of the minority in a situation which is a crisis. Right then the formal outplacement facilities. දැන් අපිට සේවකයෝ වැඩි ඉනේ. ඒ නිසා අපි කියනවා අපේ ආයතනයේ තියෙන තැපෑල නොයෙකුත් දේවල් පාවිච්චි කරලා ඉවරලා ඕගොල්ලෝ ඇප්ලයි කරන්න වෙනත් ආයතන වල. අපේ වියදමෙන් ඕගොල්ලෝ register post ඒ වගේ දේවල් වලින් යවන්න email so email විතරක් දැන් හරියන්නේ නැහැ නේ register කරලත් අරින්න ඕන copies okay so the monoikut wancha නිසා සමහර ආයතන hard copies බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා හරි එනිසා අපි හිතමු සේවකයෝ 10 දෙනෙක් වැඩි ඉතින් ආයතන කියනවා කමක් නැහැ ඔයගොල්ලෝ මාස 3ක් ඉන්න බලන්න මාස 3ක් ඇතුළ රස්සා හොයාගෙන යන්න ඒ කාලය තුල අපේ වියදම අපේ තැපෑල අපේ නොයිකුත් දේවල් computers ඒවා පාවිච්චි කරන්න इंटरव्यू वर्ल्ट एंड निवाड इंटरव्यू वर्ल्ट एंड अपे वाहन गण कमक नहीं मुखिया बोलो नो वी कैन द रिलेवेंट टॉप मैनेजर कैन टेल द ओनर मैनेजर कैन टेल लाइक दैट ओके देन यू नो फॉर्मल आउटप्लेसमेंट फैसिलिटी राइट ओके देन टर्मिनेशन दिस इज द यूजुअली द फाइनल स्ट्रैटेजी यू नो दैट इज डिसाइडेड बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू face a surplus situation, surplus condition. This is the you know a very tough this strategy. That is termination. You can kill him a sevaku ayin karan. If there are 10 employees who are in excess, then if you follow this strategy, then the company will have to terminate the employments of all the 10 people. All the 10 people. Then they you know. They are made jobless, terminated. Then they have to leave. Willingly or unwillingly, they have to leave. Right. Okay. Then next one, strategies in shortage conditions. Hingyan thiyena avasthawala gannapula upakram. Have current employees work overtime. And samalaata me strategy ekak wada honda wenna puluwan. This may be a right strategy. So assume you know our company is a small business. Our company is a small business. We, you know, rather than hiring new employees, we can ask current employees to do overtime. If you hire new employees, usually it is more expensive. For new employees, we have to pay new salaries. We have to pay EPF, ETF. The EPF kiyala kiyanne monada? Employee Provident Fund. Sevaka Arthasadhaka Aramudal gewanno. ETA. Sevaka Bharakarat Aramudal. Employee trust fund ඒ වගේ දේවල් ගෙවන්න වෙනවා ඒ නිසා සමාලාවට ඕවර්ටයිම් වගේ වැඩ ගැනීම වාසිදායක වෙන්න පුළුවන් you know so then but anyway this is not suitable for permanent jobs you know serious jobs assume a scientist you know in a laboratory සාමාන්‍ය scientist කෙනෙක් එන්නේ ඒ කියන්නේ scientist කෙනෙක් vacancy එකක් ඇතුණාම ඕවර්ටයිම් වලින් වැඩ කරන්න බොහෝ වෙලාවට බැරි වෙනවා You know, so then we will have to use another one, maybe part-time employee, maybe permanent full-time employee. Right? Then subcontract work to other firms. Another strategy: subcontract work to other firms. For example, assume we are in a garment industry. We are in a garment industry. We got a new order of producing 1,000 shirts. 1,000 shirts, but this is not a usual order. This is an unusual order. Then there is no need of you know hiring new employees to do this order. Instead, you know, we can give a subcontract to two other firms to do that one. Of course, by having a profit for us. තේරුණාද? දැන් මෙහෙම ගමු. ඒ කියන්නේ අපි garment factory එක කියලා හිතන්න. එතකොට අපිට ආව අලුත් order එකක් shirts 1000ක් නිෂ්පාදනය කරන්න. මේක හැමදාම එන order එකක් නෙමෙයි unusual order එකක්. එතකොට දැන් මේ unusual order එකක් නිසා අපිට අලුත් සේවකයෝ බඳවගෙන මේ අමතර කාර්ය කරන්න අවශ්‍ය නැහැ. අවශ්‍ය නැහැ. ඒ නිසා අපිට අපි හිතමු දැන් ඉන්න අයත් full busy. ඔක්කොටම ඕන තරම් වැඩ තියෙනවා. එහෙමනම් අපිට පුළුවන් වෙනත් ආයතන දෙකකට අපි දෙනවා contract, sub contract එක. අපිට contract එකක් ආවා අපි දෙනවා දැන් sub contract එක. ආයතන දෙකකට. ලාභයක් තියාගෙන. අපි ඒ අයගෙන් ඊට පස්සේ මිලදී අරගෙන අදාළ ප්‍රධාන contract එකට දෙනවා. Understood? So therefore this may be suitable for certain occasions. May not be suitable for other occasions. Then provide opportunities for learners for a period of time. People like you. අපි හිතමුකෝ temporary shortage එකක් තියෙන. There's a temporary shortage. දැන් ඔගොල්ලෝ වගේ graduatesලා, undergraduatesලා අවස්ථා දෙන්න පුළුවන් trainees-ලා. There are many organizations in Sri Lanka which use this strategy to solve their shortage, you know, temporary shortage conditions, problems. Then hire part-time employees, hire casual employees, hire temporary employees. ඊළඟට ප්‍රශ්නයක් තියෙනවා දැන් part time කියන්නේ මොකද්ද casual කියන්නේ මොකද්ද temporary කියන්නේ මොකද්ද you should know the differences among these three part time employees the part time employee කියන්නේ you know in case of a part time employee there is a fixed time there's a fixed time that may be 1 year that may be 6 months there is a starting time of the employment there is an ending time of the employment which are fixed part time එතකොට ඒගොල්ලෝ සාමාන්‍යයෙන් 24 hours වැඩ කරන්නේ නැති වෙන්න පුළුවන්. So then sorry. දැන් දවසකට 24 hours නේ. එතකොට working hours අපි ගන්නෙ 8ක් හැදීට. එතකොට පැයටම වැඩ කරන්නේ නැති වෙන්න පුළුවන්. පැය 4ක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් වැඩ කරන්නේ. එහෙම නැත්නම් මෙහෙම වෙන්න පුළුවන්. දවස් දැන් දවස් 5ක් වැඩ කරනවා කියලා හිතමුකෝ. පැය 8 ගන්න. පැය 40ක්. එතකොට එයා දවස් 5ක් වැඩ කරන්නේ නැතුව part time කියන්නේ දවස් 2ක් වැඩ කරනවා. Ah, that is also possible. Instead of working for 5 days you know the employee is supposed to work for 2 days that is a part time employee otherwise per day so assume a normal employee has to work for 8 hours so instead of working for 8 hours part time employee has to work for only 4 hours per day okay then what is casual employee casual you know there's no definite starting time there is no definite ending time of the employment any time you know any time the employer can terminate a casual employee without giving any notice then samanya neetiya gattot ema if you think of the labor law the part time employee kenek askaranna ba ek partum kiyanna ba 1 month notice ekak denno ema naththam 1 month salary ekak denno now casual employee kenekota කිසිම දැනුම් දීමක් කර without giving any notification අපි හිතමු උදේ ආවා වැඩට 8ට දවල් 11 වෙනකොට කියන්න පුළුවන් නැත්නම් දවල් 1 වෙනකොට කියන්න පුළුවන් we don't need you thank you very much for your working up to now so therefore you have to finish your work by 2 o'clock and thank you very much this is your remuneration or your payment for the work that you have done for that number of hours ओके कैशुअल कहने का ओन वेला सामान्य कैशुअल एम्प्लॉई कहने कैशुअल वर्क का तमाय करने देन वेरी विस्तार कहने बे बट एनीवे जनरली यू ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड राइट देन टेंपररी टेंपररी एम्प्लॉई सो नॉर्मली अ टेंपररी एम्प्लॉई आल्सो हैज अ फिक्स्ड स्टार्टिंग टाइम फिक्स्ड एंडिंग टाइम ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयमेंट बट टेंपररी एम्प्लॉई हैज टू वर्क एज अ परमानेंट एम्प्लॉई बट रियली नॉट अ परमानेंट एम्प्लॉई But temporary employee has to perform all the relevant duties of the job, which are done by a permanent employee. Ekena sthira seva daayake karana okkoma weda tika temporary employee kenekota karanna puluwa. Now temporary employee kenekota there is fixed time. Now me temporary period deka extend karanna puluwa. You know, extend karanna puluwa. Right. But there's a possibility of giving an extension to a temporary employee. Then the permanent killer, can a CLO pass on with all, you know, facilities and all this, permanent employee. Again, until the person's retirement age, the employee can work, provided that the employee doesn't engage in very bad misconduct. That misconduct, again, naraka hasirimak karanne nattan, vinaya virodhi wedak karanne nattan, sthira sevakayekuta samanyen retire wenakama weda karanna puluwan. Permanent killer gana ekai. හැබැයි ඉතින් පර්මනන්ට් එම්ප්ලොයි දැන් වැඩ නැති වුණොත් එහෙම අයින් කරන්න සිද්ධ වෙනවා පර්මනන්ට් එම්ප්ලොයි කෙනෙක් වුණා බට් ජෙනරලි යු නෝ දැර් ඉස් පර්මනන්ස් දැර් ඉස් ජොබ් සෙකියුරිටි ඉන් කේස් ඔෆ් අ ෆුල් ටයිම් එම්ප්ලොයි එතකොට ඕල් ද ෆැසිලිටීස් වි හැව් ටු ගිව් ටු අ ෆුල් ටයිම් එම්ප්ලොයි රයිට් දෙන් වට් ඉස් දිස් කැපිටල් සබ්ස්ටිටියුෂන් ප්‍රාග්ධන ආදේශ කරණි අපි තොම දැන් මෙතන ෂෝටේජ් ගන්න තියෙන හිඟයක් නේ තියෙන අපි තොම නිෂ්පාදන සේවකයෝ 20ක් අඩු වෙලා ඉන්නවා අපේ ෆැක්ටරි so as you know there is a shortage of 20 production employees in our factory rather than hiring part time 20 production employees or temporary 20 production employees we can do this capital substitution that means assume we can buy and install two new machines one machine can do the work of you know 10 production workers then ek machine api thamu machine dekak ganna ek machine ekkada karanna puluwa production employees la 10 denek karana wada etawada then production employees la 20 ka higiyak ne thiyenne idu machine deyak gaththama isu prashnayak ne production aluthen production employees la 20 ak ganna onne machine deka vitarak aragena install karana that's the meaning of capital substitution but normally you know in a situation where there are many employees sorry there are many people who are seeking jobs there is a high employment I mean high rate of unemployment in the country use of capital substitution is not moral not ethical eka sajachara na eken godak minissu rassa nathuwa innokota me wage kramayak yoda ganne eka honda ne it is a great thing that you know if you can give many job opportunities to many people right okay then now we have self assignment select any organization before that right the last step you know last step of our process okay in order to save time I have not so they I think you can remember or perhaps you know go to that process then the last step is evaluate or assess the human resource planning effect that you know evaluate කරන්න ඕනේ කියන්නේ අපි මේ දක්වා කරපු වැඩ මේ steps ටිකේ කරපු වැඩ දැන් ඔබ නම් human resource plan මේ දක්වා කරපු වැඩ ටික හොඳින් කරාද හොඳට plan එක හැදුවද අවශ්‍ය පරිදි vacancies estimate කරාද එතකොට මොනවද බැරි වුනේ අපි යොදාගත්ත දේත estimation يعني forecasting techniques හොඳද නැද්ද you know we have to do a final evaluation you know about what we have done of the all these previous steps of our process whether we have done correctly the estimation of vacancies did we miss any important vacancy you know so likewise right okay then self assignment select any organization or division section of an organization accessible to you do a human resource planning and prepare a report based on what you have planned so if possible you can do that this is a self assignment so you know now I have given knowledge you know mainly what we are giving to you is knowledge not really this case but when you prepare really replacement charts staffing tables and all these actually for an actual organization definitely you will get skills so called skills knowledge is essential skill also is essential it is from a teaching like this it is difficult for us to you know develop your skill in human resource planning therefore that's why we have decided to give this self assignment so it is up to you if you are a serious learner then please do it Please be serious and do it. I know that there are many serious learners who are listening to me now. I know that. There are maybe, you know, there are maybe some students, they are not that serious. Anyway, then the case, you know, X Development and Administration Department, that will be done under tutorial classes. Before finishing, you know, let me do another exercise. The ant. This is about a story of the so-called ant. Ant can kumbia. A fable or maybe not. Fable can gotapu katawak venda pulwa. Emanathang maybe an actual story. Right. Every day, a small ant arrives at work very early and starts work immediately. Gana hama dawasakama kuda kumbiyek enawa. Wedata බොහොම උදෑසනින් එනවා. ඒ වගේම වහාම වැඩ පටන් ගන්නවා. එහෙමෙන් බොරුවට රස්තිය දුවේවි. කෑම කක්කා දව වෙන උදේට කෑම කනවා ඇවිල්ලා වැඩ කරගන්නේ. ඊට පස්සේ ටොයිලට් යනවා නෝ දේවල් කරනවා. එහෙම කරන්නේ නැතුව you know so this employee this is small ant you know arrives at work every early and then starts work immediately. And then she produces a lot and she was happy. Her productivity is a lot. That means she is a high performer. Okay, then the chief, who is the chief, the boss, a lion, was surprised to see that the ant was working without supervision. Again, boss can ek natu, adikshan ek natu, tamai ant vedakaran. Kochar hondad. You know? So what a good situation. Where, you know, there is an employee. This is, you know, here that ant. And is a high performer, has been working without getting any supervision. Then he thought, how the lion, he thought if the ant can produce so much without supervision, wouldn't she produce even more if she had a supervisor? Again, supervisor can make natuwa mechchara weda karana na, supervisor can make dala kochchara weda karayida kiyala hithuna. Thought. Okay, then, so he recruited a cockroach. Ekena karapotte gatta. Then who had extensive experience as a supervisor and who was famous for writing excellent reports. Ekena visishta vartha liyanna puluwa. Bohoma janapriyathwayak tiena. Bohoma palapuruddak tiena. Supervisor kenek me adala lion, ekena boss gatta. The cockroach's first decision was to set up a clocking in attendance system. Attendance system meke clock ekak dama. Clocking. Ekena welawata weda karanna naththam ekena card ekak lakunu karanna no clocking in attendance system. Okay then he also needed a secretary to help him write and type his reports. Secretary kenek awashya una. Eyage wartha liyanna. Then he recruited a spider who managed the archives and monitored all phone calls. Okay, understood. Spider kene gatta. Then the lion was delighted with the cockroach's reports and asked him to produce graphs to describe production rates and to analyze trends. Ekena dan me dena cockroach supervisor dena reports walin delighted you know I can more than happy delighted kiyala kiyanne in single kiyana aananda janaka tattweta patthuna you know higher degree of happiness the lion was and then asked him to produce graphs to describe production rates and to analyze trends wedi unada wedi wenne kohomada kochchara pramanayakinda mona ansa walada kaageda you know analyze trends so that he could use them for presentations at board meetings because lion has a board meeting. Lion is the managing director as you. In the board, you know, in the board, there are owners of the organization. Right. Then so the cockroach had to buy a new computer and laser printer. And recruited a fly to manage the IT department. On a message that they can fly to manage the IT department, the weather good after, you know. Reports liyanna ona computer ekak gatta laser printer gatta so then There is an IT department now. Okay, then the ant who had once been so productive and relaxed hated this new plethora of paperwork. Plethora again, the imak konakna the goda, paperwork goda goda gehunu. And meetings, which used up most of her time. Kelavarakne the meetings. A meeting nisa meyage watina kaalen sahana pramanayak gatha una. එතකොට නොයෙකුත් report ලියන්න සෑහෙන කාලයක් සෑහෙන ශ්‍රමයක් ගත වුණා. ඒ නිසා the may ant කියන අමතක කරන්න එපා. Who had been so productive and relaxed. බොහොම relax එකේ බොහොම ඵලදායී විදිහට වැඩ කරපු කෙනෙක් තමයි ant කියන්නේ. Now hated කියන්නේ වෛර කරා දැන් මේ system එකට. අලුත් ක්‍රම ඔය වේදී. The lions came to the conclusion that it was high time to nominate a person in charge of the department where the ant work dantamai velawa honda velawak kiyala hituwa me ant weda karana department eke den in charge kene nominate karan then the position was given to the cicada kiyana rahayyane rahayya cicada whose first decision was to buy a carpet and an ergonomic chair for his office what is ergonomics Not economics, huh? Economics. Economics kiyala kiyanne tamange sharireta tamange usata tamange maatata tamanta galahaki chalaneyanta pahasuwana putuwa. Pahasuwana putuwa. Eyana pudgalayata pahasuwana. User friendly chair. The chair that is friendly, convenient. To this officer in charge. Right. Then the new person in charge The cicada also needed a computer and a personal assistant, whom he brought from his previous department to help him prepare a work and budget control strategic optimization plan. On a work and budget control strategic optimization plan, kelega. A new system of management, right? Okay, then the department. Where the ant works is now a sad place. The ant weda karapu bohoma santoshing, The ant was happy, had been happy, then had been highly productive. But now not that happy, not that productive, because the place has become a sad place. Where nobody laughs anymore. And everybody has become upset. Then it was at that time that The cicada convinced the boss, the lion, of the absolute necessity to start a climatic study of the environment. And මේ වෙලාවේ තමයි දැන් මිනිස්සු upset, නොයෙකුත් අය කලින් productivity එක නැහැ. ඒ නිසා දැන් අදාළ cicada, ඒ කියන්නේ officer in charge of that production department, එයා යෝජනාවක් කරා. එයා අවබෝධ කරලා දුන්නා දැන් තමයි නියම වෙලාව. පරිසරය පිළිබඳ අධ්‍යයනයක් කරන්න. And having reviewed the charges for running the ants department, the lion found out that the production was much less than before. So he recruited the owl, a prestigious and renowned consultant, to carry out an audit and suggest solutions. Then productivity එක බැහැලා, job satisfaction එක බැහැලා. හිතමු නැතු විදිය දැන් මේ සම්බන්ධ දැන් ප්‍රශ්නනේ the company is facing now the company is having serious problems low productivity low job satisfaction a bad atmosphere of the organization people are not supported lack of cooperation we can assume based on lack of productivity and then lack of job satisfaction then renounced consultant උපදේශකෙක් බඳව ගන්න. The audit එකක් කරන්න. මේ ප්‍රශ්න වලට මොනවාද හේතු ඊට පස්සේ වට විසතු. The owl spent 3 months in the department and came up with an enormous report, large, huge, in several volumes that concluded the department is overstaffed. තේරුණාද? ඒ කියන්නේ department එක දැන් වැඩි there is a surplus of employees in the department that's the That's the reason for low productivity. That's the reason for low job satisfaction. Then guess who the lion fires first, or whom, according to British English, the lion fires first. Kaudadan issallamadan ayin karan. The ant, of course, because she showed lack of motivation and had a negative attitude. Okay, so then, can you understand? What can you learn from this? What can you learn from this? So one thing is bad investigation. Wrong judgment of the reasons. Also wrong judgment of the solution. Also too much of specialization. Unnecessary people, unnecessary works. Again, if there is a genuine need to hire someone, we have to do that. Bad job designing. Bad job designing. There's no job analysis. There's no job description for the job. There's no job specification for the job. So we can assume that. We can analyze like that. So therefore, another message that we can learn is, we should not do human resource management to hurt high performers. We have to keep high performers because they are the people who contribute immensely to productivity, to achieve the primary goals of the organization. Therefore, we have to develop HR systems to improve their motivation, to improve their productivity further. Also, another big problem in this fable or in these stories, the lion has never consulted. Lion has never listened to this one and has never taken any suggestion from the down person who really works. There are many organizations, even within university, within hospital, there are certain people who genuinely run the things, run the show, take the burdens of the work, who really serve the customers. They are not really the top people, the head of the department or the, head of the institution, not the vice chancellor, not the dean, or not the, in a hospital, not the medical director, So the actual people, who are the surgeons, who are the relevant doctors, who really, become committed to serve the patients. The critical employees. So never, turn down critical employees. So that's a good message that you can learn. Okay, all right. I hope you understood. Then we will see you in future soon. Good night.